supremacy, attributed to Dr. Francis Cress Wilson and Mr. Neelie Fuller. As long as white supremacy is alive and well, a white man's heaven is a black man's hell. Uncle Sam and Jim Crow are the arch deceivers of the game, and that old skinhead Ku Klux spirit is still the same. As a man-child of the sun, I've got melanin on my mind. Can't afford to be simply deaf, dumb, and blind when white supremacy is the bottom line. And as long as white supremacy is alive and still kicking ass, freedom, justice, and equality will never come to pass. Many look, but few ever really see. The most unjust dynamic in the world is white supremacy. Hi, I'm Danny Queen, and welcome to another edition of Color Me Poetry. I'd like to welcome my most illustrious guest, the Honorable Dr. Francis Cress Wilson. Welcome,
Dr. Wilson. I'm glad to be here, Danny.
Tell us a little bit about yourself and how you got started in your career.
Well, I am a general psychiatrist and child psychiatrist. I'm from Chicago, but I have been in Washington, D.C. since 1958 when I came to medical school at Howard University and did all of my training in general psychiatry at St. Elizabeth's Hospital and child psychiatry at Children's Hospital here in Washington. And I have been interested. Things didn't start out that way, but I became interested in how to solve the mental health problems and other health care problems faced by black people. And I began to realize that until the problem of racism was solved, that black people were going to have difficulty as far as their health collectively, totally, is concerned. And I made up my mind, let me find out about racism.
Now, how many of your colleagues agree with you? How many know what you're saying is true and agree with you?
Well, I don't think that, I understand your question, but that's not an important consideration. In other words, when you step into new territory, the reason that you have to step into new territory is because other people haven't been there before you. So it would be like asking Einstein, if you will, do your colleagues agree with relativity theory? He felt that there was a vacuum in an area of understanding. He moved into the vacuum. Eventually, people caught up to what he had in mind.
As I find that as an artist, sometimes it's like that, too. Because sometimes, not that you intend to be, but sometimes you have a tendency to be ahead of the pack, if you will.
Well, that you may not. You see, mm-hmm. The artist who may step in a new direction doesn't say, I am going to step into a new mm-hmm. direction to be ahead of the pack. No, mm-hmm. They are inspired or motivated or moved as an individual person to go in one direction, mm-hmm. and it then becomes apparent that they are ahead of the pack.
I know, for instance, I did a piece in my book called South Africa some time ago, and at the time when I wrote it, some 10, 12 years ago, it wasn't at the forefront.
Exactly.
And now, you see the changes coming about themselves.
Exactly.
But at the time when I wrote that piece, I wasn't thinking, I'm going to be ahead of...
Exactly.
I wasn't even thinking in terms of that at all.
Well, as I move around, whenever I move around the city and I started writing about racism effectively or thinking about it intensively in 1967 and started talking about it openly from 1970 following my writing about the Cress Theory of Color Confrontation and racism, white supremacy. And now, whenever I move about town, I could be in Woody's, I could be at Union Station, I could be on the street. Somebody might come up to me and say, let me shake your hand, or you don't know me, but I started hearing you talk in 1970, and I knew you were crazy. Do you see? But now, 20 years later, I understand what you were talking about. And so that's very interesting to me, to have people say that, but it meant that you were talking about something in a manner that was unfamiliar and people mm-hmm. couldn't connect with it. But as the flow of time moves on, do you see, then you become right on time as far as a larger number of people.
So at the time, when you were working at Howard, people thought you were very radical and all.
You mean when I was teaching at Howard University? Mm-hmm. My experience at Howard, because I had gone to medical school there and, knew the people who were on the faculty and they knew me as a student, I taught there from 1968 to 1975. And people didn't, they considered that I was Francis Cress or Francis mm-hmm. Cress Wilson. And I don't feel that they felt generally that I was that radical person. Maybe I became after other people said, well, she's radical. Okay, then we have to look at this person who we are very familiar with as being this radical.
And now?
Person.
Now it's a lot different. Because a lot of things that you had said back then had come to pass.
Well, this is what people say.
Mm-hmm. Wow. Let's talk also about your theory.
The crest theory?
The crest theory.
Well, the crest theory...